Well, we're on air with Sig Anderson. How are you, Sig?
Oh, very good, very good. What a good day to be in the cinema. Cold and wet, raining. Why not? But one of the big openings this year, or this week actually, we have the much anticipated Napoleon, which is a big extravaganza, quite a big blockbuster film, which has been unfortunately held up for a year for COVID. It's finally released now, so it's in cinemas now, coming in at 2.5 hours, quite long.
There's been a lot of long movies this year.
Yeah, and there's talk about some cinemas are thinking about maybe putting in intermissions, and why not?
So yes.
There and have a bit of a break and go through this, but the cinemas like that, of course, probably can sell more food and drink, but many directors don't want that. They want to see their films straight through the way it's meant to be seen. So we'll see how we go on that one. But this is a pretty long one. And it's held up by COVID of last year pretty much. And some of the cinemas closed. So it's finally finally able to open, and you can see it right around, including, as I say, IMAX. It's just on the big screen. And it's incredible because Napoleon, back in 1799, was only 30 years old when he used a bit of a coup to seize power and actually crown himself Emperor of France. And he was pretty brilliant on the military field, and he went from there and expanded the borders of France quite considerably. Unfortunately, though, his wars cost millions of lives and ended up with France's defeat and occupation in the end. And many in France still reckon that Napoleon is a champion of nationalism as well as civic equality. So, obviously associated with the French Revolution. He's ended his days, of course, in exile on the British island of St. Helena after his famous defeat of Waterloo. So, quite a life. But the film stars Joaquin Phoenix in a quietly intense and brooding role, and also Vanessa Kirby as his beloved Josephine. And directed by Ridley Scott, he's making this quite a spectacle. Outspoken English director, and this covers 32 years of his life towards the end of his reign. And it's pretty amazing. We have the very beginning of the film. We have the very beginning. It's a startling opening scene. Napoleon is seen, and he hasn't risen to power yet, but he's seen in the crowd watching. We don't know whether he actually did this. Factual correctness to some of this is in question, but in the film anyway, he's watching the guillotine death of Marie Antoinette, the public beheading. And that's a pretty startling scene to start with. So, much of the film is based on Abel Gance's 1927 novel, Napoleon, also a painting of Napoleon before the Sphinx. And there's a doubt whether or not he actually did bomb the Sphinx with his famous cannonballs. And also there's a bit of a reference to a gladiator. And this is Joaquin Phoenix starred as another emperor, in the son actually, in the earlier Ridley Scott film, The Gladiator, with Russell Crowe. But it's a pretty amazing film. It's a lot of very intense battle scenes. Those cannonballs are pretty amazing. And they show quite graphic. We've got a lot going on, a lot of explosions, even exploding horses, and it's pretty amazing. The relationship between Josephine and Napoleon, Joaquin Phoenix again and Vanessa Kirby, it didn't leave me too impressed. You know, it wasn't real connection. There wasn't a real passion thing there, I think, you know, between those two. I don't think they really gelled too well in that role. There was a lot going on. So it's pretty well the story between those two and a lot of battle scenes. And we have brooding intensity from Joaquin Phoenix playing the role. He is the famous short man, and he charges through things and is quite pretty quiet and affected in some of these things. So we have him coming in contact with Josephine when she gets out of prison, and he comes across from Corsica, of course. So the battle scenes are, as I say, are pretty amazing. They're very, very well staged, with casts of thousands, and pretty spectacular. It looks even better, as I say, if you are able to see it at IMAX big screen, and you can see a lot there. Later on, when they weren't able to have a child, there was problems with the marriage and threats of divorce, and they went through there. And in the end, we have a really good actor, Rupert Everett, who comes on as Duke of Wellington in the Battle of Waterloo. Mm. And he's quite good there. So it's pretty good in that Belgian field. So you want to check that out. It's Napoleon, and screening now. 2.5 hours, very long. So be sure to prepare before you go on that one. And it's screening right around as well as IMAX. So that's recommended. Quite spectacular. Now, do we have a few messages, or will I go on?
Yes, it's time for some messages, and we'll
stroke
be back soon.
Can happen to anybody at any age. The best way to help someone is to learn the signs of stroke and know how to act fast. F is for face. Has their face drooped? A is for arms. Can they lift both arms? S is for speech. Is their speech slurred? Do they understand you? T is for time. Call 000. Time is critical. If you see any of these symptoms, act fast. Learn the signs of stroke and you could save a life. Go to strokefoundation.org.au/fast to find out more.
Back on air with Sig Anderson, and Sig's been talking about Napoleon, and that sounds absolutely intriguing. And what's our next movie?
It's a pretty spectacular film. Next up, we have The Royal Hotel, and this is an Australian film, which is quite interesting, and it's at the other end of the field. It's a smaller film, but it's still very intriguing. It harkens back to that early book and film, Wake and Fright, an Australian film, very similar to that. And in this one, we have two American backpackers, played by Julie Garner and Jessica Henwick. And they're young women who run out of money, as backpackers sometimes do, and they got to get a temporary job, as they do, and sort of get a bit of quid to continue their trip. And so they get this job in an outback hotel. So they're trundling along this bus out in the middle of nowhere, and they come across this hotel, which is a pretty broken down place with a wooden balconies, and they ended up working this hotel, working the bar there. And here they've got to put up with some of the more rougher gentlemen that come in there, and drink is popular, drink is great and everything, and there's a little bit of seething underlying threats and violence, which possibly will happen with some of these women, and the way things go there. And these guys, they're sometimes a little bit over the top, and there's always a little bit of hostility and a few little jibes coming on the side, and you're not really sure whether you're safe, you're not really sure whether things are going to be going on, and what's going to happen with these women. And they played very well by Hugo Weaving is the boss of the hotel, and he gets in with them and tells them to get a bit of a smile once in a while. And the guys like a bit of a smile, like a pretty girl, give them a drink and that sort of thing. And there's a bit of hostility towards them in a jovial sort of way, which have an underlying sense of menace. And the drinking culture is pretty incredible because the way it goes through, things get a little bit crazy when people get a bit of a drink in them, and there are a few hostilities somewhere there. The director, Kitty Green, her dad actually grew up in a pub, and she was out near Mildura, and her mother was Ukrainian, and she had to work out how to get things there, fit in there with society as well in a similar way. But it's pretty intriguing the way things go for some of this film, and I think you'll find that it's an underlying menace in here that sort of grows on you a bit. And how do these girls deal with this thing, and how do as the women, and how do they go through this, and what sort of things befall them? I can't really give it away, but it's not a horror story. It's not particularly violent. It's just this underlying menace in what's going on there. So you might want to check that one out. It's out now, coming in at 105 minutes. Once again, a new Australian film called The Royal Hotel. And just real quick, before it's time to go in a few minutes, I'd also like to bring your attention to the Iranian Film Festival. And this is screening right now at the Cinema Nova right through to December 3. And you can see several films there. And a couple of them that you might want to check out. First of all, we have The Locust. And that's the opening night film, also screening several times throughout the festival. We have a 40-year-old woman who's written a script based on her own life, and she's facing the judgment of other people who reckon she's a bastard for doing this. And this is a bit more difficult. And we have a woman who left Iran, and also another woman who was temporarily detained there for political remarks, and of course, from there. Also another film you might want to check out is called Winners, and this is an interesting film, and it was the official entry for the Oscars and also nominated for several others. And we have a small provincial Iranian town. Children are working pretty hard to support their families. The kids are out there doing it pretty good. But a 9-year-old Yagaya and his friend Leila, they actually find a precious stone while they're out working. And they, a precious statue, actually, and they are trying to find the owner to the statue, and they also love cinema a lot, so it goes from there. And another film you might want to check out at the Iranian Film Festival, which is screening now, right through to December 3, we have The Night Guardian, and this is directed by Rezi Mirkimi. And during a drought, a man leaves his village, and he actually finds a job as a night guardian of a complex that's under construction. And at this deserted construction site, something not too correct is going on. He's not sure what it is, and there's suspicious things going on, and he investigates and tries to find out what's going on. That's called The Night Guardian, and that's currently screening at the Iranian Film Festival, so you might want to check that out. If you want to find out more about that screening now, you can go at iffa.net.au. You can check that out, as well as other films like The Royal Hotel and the big blockbuster Napoleon. Lots of films, Hillary, and that's what I have time for.
Thank you very much, Sig. We've been listening to Sig Anderson and Valley Lifestyles with Hillary and Tony.